Here we are, guys. You guys have asked me so much for this sneaker collection video, but at least I'm able to make the boot collection video. I do not have much collection when it comes to the boots as much as I have sneakers, but here I got 10 options, technically 8 options, but overall 2 more are the pseudo options, which are actually high top sneakers, but you can wear during the winter seasons. A quick disclaimer, guys, many of the boots which I own may not be the recent purchases, so I may not be able to find the links. However, if I find any alternative pieces or similar versions, I will leave the links in the description below. Let's start with the lace-up boots, and I will start with my oldest one and also my favorite one. If you can see this very closely, this is a high ankle black lace-up boots from United Colors of Benetton. This I got it in a size of EU43, which equals to size 9. This I got it almost like 4 years back. This is made of genuine leather. This is not a polyurethane leather version. And if you can see this very closely, they have this broke kind of stitchings across. And also, rather than going with the black color sole as well as the heel, they have differentiated with the beige and brown with the stitches going across. These are my go-to boots since last 3 years. And the use case was pretty rough, I think. Maybe within a year, it's time to replace these boots. At the time, they were retailing at 7,000 rupees, but I got them at a price point of 5,000 rupees. I will leave a similar version of the Zara link in the description below. Overall, they give the ample comfort, and they do have the zippers on the side. As we are done with the boot number one, what are the next lace-up boots I have? I think, yeah, this one. These are from H&M, guys. Yes, these are the boot number two, the lace-up. These are the suede leather versions. This is the normal genuine leather, and this is the suede leather. You need to be versatile among the choices you make, because generally the boots, those are not the super affordable options, and those are not the options which you will replace every single year. So you have to make sure that you go for different choice of materials in the limited options and limited budget available to you. It's in the very darker shade of a brown, and it is a high ankle one. And as always, here they have gone with the desert boots kind of vibe with the undersole. Overall, the quality is pretty great. I use this maybe 5 to 6 times by now, because I got them recently, maybe one and a half month back. These retails at 7,000 rupees. These are available in the H&M stores right now as well. I'm not sure about the online availability, because I checked before shooting this video. Unfortunately, online they are not available at this point of time, but in H&M store they are available. You can get this at a price point of 7,000, and in case if you have the H&M membership, they are giving the bonus points and 10% off, which will not hurt, right? These are pretty comfortable, but make sure that you size down. My boot size generally is 8. I have gone with the 7.5 here. Also, this is available in the black color as well. It is a color which is super versatile, because it's not a loud color. It is a color which can be easily matched with most pieces in your wardrobe. That you have to consider while buying these boots. And overall, this is a genuine suede leather option, not a synthetic suede generally H&M offers for most of their pieces. This is a genuine suede option. That's the reason it is priced at 7,000 rupees. If it is a synthetic suede, this would have been priced at 4,000 rupees. If I'm not wrong, when I went for shopping, there is a 4,000 rupees version which looks exactly the same in a black or navy blue color, which is a synthetic suede. The previous one, the boot number two, which you have seen, it is a super dark version of the brown color. This is much more inclined towards the genuine leather versions, which you see in the brown color, not the tan brown color. I do not have a tan brown boots, particularly in the lace-ups, because those are not super versatile in general when it comes to the lace-ups. If you go for the tan brown, I do understand that generally it is the color which is associated, but it don't work with majority of my outfit. And this is a boot from Jack & Jones. It is having a considerable amount of heel portion. It's much more into the chunky boots kind of a vibe with the sole and the ruggedness it goes with. And as I mentioned, it is also having the side zipper. It is a genuine leather boot from Jack & Jones. It's priced somewhere around 6,000 or 7,000 rupees. I got this almost a year back at a price point of 3,500 to 4,000 when they were discounted on Myntra. For 3,500 rupees, getting a genuine leather boots of this quality, it's a very good investment. I got this in a size of 8, guys. Make sure that you go true to size when it comes to the Jack & Jones boots. These three boots forms the core of my high ankle lace-up boots. As we are still with the lace-up boots, I have a mid-ankle lace-up boots that is also from Jack & Jones, And coming to the boot number 4, these are the mid-ankles, genuine leather options. But however, when it comes to the brown, this is the brown which is much more inclined to the tan brown or a camel brown color. The warmth it provides during the winter seasons because of the cushioning it have inside. It have so much padding inside, and also they tone down this color by using the almost a grayish faded suede kind of a laces. And also when it comes to the sole portion as well, they have gone with the gum sole kind of a effect when it comes to the sole. That's the reason I have gone with this option, even though I'm not a big fan of this color. For a price point of 2000 or 2500, I think these are worth the investment, and I almost got them maybe 3 years before. Officially, now we are done with the lace-up boots. I have got only 4 of them, but I'm pretty much covered with the colors which I would need for a lace-up boots. As we are done with the lace-up boots, now let's move into the Chelsea options. And with the Chelsea options, let's start with one of my favorite color. Yes, this is also a brown color, but this is the color which you should get if it is your first Chelsea boot. I got this from H&M pretty recently. If you haven't watched the review of this H&M Chelsea boots, I will leave that video link somewhere on the iCard. This I got it in a size of 7, and I got them for 3000 rupees. These are my recent purchases. And overall, when it comes to the sole as well, these are the TPR thermoplastic rubber soles, which gives the illusion of a leather sole. Overall, at this price point, these serve better because they do not have much competition at this price point when it comes to the Chelsea boot offerings, and that too, a Chelsea boot which looks this good. This is an interesting version because this is a black Chelsea boot, but these are called as boot sneakers. Yes, because majority of the shoe relates to boot. And when it comes to the sole, they have gone with the sneaker sole or a trainer sole to add the supreme comfort to the shoe. These are one of the comfortable Chelsea sneakers I own, guys. Really, at a price point of 3000 rupees, the comfort it offers, and also it's a high ankle Chelsea boots in the black color, which is going to be super versatile. These are available in the store, I think, as well as online as well. I will leave the link in the description. But there is a minor caveat when it comes to this shoe, which may impact the durability because of how narrow this shaft is, and this do not have much elasticity. So you will be having tough time while putting your feet into the shoe. It's getting easier after a few wears, but that's a minor caveat. Overall, I'm happy with this purchase for 3000 rupees. Based on when I released this video, by this time, you must have seen the review for this boot, or else you will see that very, very soon. Now let's get into the 7th one. These are pretty much folded because like how I kept it, I just forgot to keep them in the horizontal way. Rather, I kept the vertical way and closed the box. You need to take care, guys, when it comes to these boots. So this is a light beige color H&M Chelsea boot, which I reviewed very, very recently. If you haven't watched that video, make sure that you watch the video in order to find the full details of this boot. I'm not going to get into each and every aspect. This one, as I am pretty much covered with the brown as well as the black color, this would be the third color to go as per my opinion. So that's the reason I have gone with this. These are little expensive when compared to the 3000 rupees options. These are priced at 4000 rupees. But overall, the shape of these boots, it is having the toe shape a little bit rounded when compared to the other two boots. And also the comfort is much more better, and the fit is little snug. These are also one of my best pickups, and these also one of the interesting color and a different color I have among my boot collection. Moving on to the piece number 8, these are the boots which I had almost from 3 years, and they didn't age well. These are the genuine suede leather options, which is in this olive gray color from Jack and Jones, which I got it in a size 8. These are priced at 5000 rupees. At the time, I got them for almost 3500 or 3000 rupees. I took care of them really, really well, guys, but they didn't age well. Few of the boots which I have from Jack and Jones and also from the UCB, I donated them pretty recently. Otherwise, my boot collection would be somewhere around 13 to 14. But however, I'm happy with whatever I have because these are the quality options, and these are the options which are looking good at this point of time. And the honorable mentions, which are not exactly the boots, don't be mad at me. I know that these are not the boots, these are much more of a high top sneakers, but these are the knitted options and the sock style boots, which I can say these are much more towards the sneaker boots, or at least the pseudo version of the sneaker boots. And let's start with the piece number 9. These are the knitted sock type high top sneakers from Zara, which I got it maybe in the last season, 5 or 6 months back. I got them at a price point of 4,000 rupees. Right now, there is an alternative version which is available at 3,590, but it's not a high ankle, it's a mid ankle, and there are minor differences when it comes to the sole. But you pretty much get everything which you can see in this boot. It is super comfortable. I literally feel like I'm just wearing socks and I'm walking on an insole. That's how comfortable it is. And these are the combinations which you should be having in terms of the colors, going with the neutral colors of the black as well as the white. This is one of my favorite sneakers, and this I wanted to include in this boot collection because I mostly wear them during the winter season and partly during the rainy season, even though you're not supposed to. And being the material, it is a little tough to clean because it's a sock material, right? So you have to be really careful while cleaning these kind of knitted shoes in general. Moving on to the last boot, and this I have with me almost from last 2 years. These are the knitted or sock boots from Aeropostale. I got this in a size of 9. These are the mid-ankle ones. These are the high tops. Because of the color, I got them, and also I got it for almost 1800 rupees. For 1800 rupees, I felt that these are worth giving it a try. These are not one of the comfortable sock boots in terms of the insole cushioning, but however, this material is comfortable. I used it pretty roughly, guys. This sneaker, I used it a lot, but this held up very nicely. I used to play even table tennis with these mid-top sneakers, but it held up really, really well. And also, the color being the gray color, it goes well with majority of the pieces in my closet. Overall, for a price point of 1800 rupees, I think this is a very, very good investment. That's it, guys. I'm super lazy in general in order to clean or maintain these many boots or sneakers. That's the reason generally these videos getting postponed a lot. I promise you guys, I will do the sneaker collection video as well, but give me some time. I will definitely do that. I hope overall you found this video useful in some way, even though I'm just showing my boot collection in this video. If you enjoyed this video and if you want my sneaker collection video, make sure that you hit the like button. Once this video cross 750 likes, I will make sure that I will do my sneaker collection video for sure. That's it from me. I think I will see you guys in my next video.